everyone. We are going to continue our lesson from the other day, but before we do that, I want to go to the homework that you were supposed to do, and I asked you to make a chart for each of the five problems on worksheet 7.5A. So I want you to check out the charts. Make sure you got them right. Okay. If you didn't, try to figure out where you went wrong. Of course, you can pause this video at any time. And then we're going to continue. I do want to talk about number five real quick. Okay, so just looking at number five, what we know from this, the benefit of this really, is that we don't have any positive real roots. So that's going to help us when we're trying to determine what numbers we're going to check to see if they are roots. So let's jump back a few pages to the problem that we left off with. Okay, and we're going to talk about now that we know the nature, the possible nature of the roots, how will we decide what numbers to check to see if they are roots or zeros of our function? So the way we do that is we actually are going to make a fraction. Whoops, I have an eraser for some reason. We're going to make a fraction that is, the numerator is going to come from the factors of the constant, and the denominator will come from the factors of the lead coefficient. So in this case, the constant is 12. We don't care that it's negative. And the lead coefficient is 2. So in this case, our p over q value will be the factors of 12. So all the numbers that will divide evenly into 12, which are these 1, 2, 3, 4, 6, and 12. And we're going to divide that by the factors of the lead coefficient, which is 2. So it's just 1 and 2. Now what we do is we make all the possible fractions out of these numerators and denominators. So of course, all of these numbers over 1 will just be 1, 2, 3, 4, 6, and 12. But now we have to start matching up 1 over 1. I'm sorry, whoops. Let's erase that. 1 over 2. So in other words, 1 half. 2 over 2 is 1, so we already got that. 3 over 2. 4 over 2 is 2. 6 over 2 is 3. 12 over 2 is 6. So we already have those numbers. Because we are able to get positive and negative numbers, we're going to test positive and negative versions of these numbers. So positive and negative 1. That might, one of those might be a root, positive negative 2, positive negative 3, and so on. So now it's going to be a bit of guess and check. So we will set up our pocket. We will look at our coefficients. So we've got 2, 7, negative 7, and negative 12. So 2, 7, negative 7, and negative 12. And remember, with synthetic division, we bring down the lead coefficient. We are looking for a zero of the function. So we know that we need 12 here so that we can get a zero. And now we're going to test some values in our pocket to see which one actually works. So we could just take a guess here. I'm going to test 1. 1 times 2 is 2. Add down, we get 9. 1 times 9 is 9. Add down, we get 2. That's not going to work to give us 12. So we erase and we try another number. So we might say, well, I'm going to try, whoops, I'm going to try negative 1. Negative 1 times 2 is negative 2. Add down. Negative 1 times negative 5, I'm sorry, negative 1 times 5 is negative 5. Add down. Hey, negative 1 times negative 12 is 12. So we've just found one of the zeros of our functions. So this is good news. Because now, first of all, we know one of our zeros is negative 1. And now we can use our depressed polynomial with all of the quadratic methods that we know. So we've got 2x squared plus 5x minus 12, and we set it equal to 0. And We say, well, okay, can we factor this? So 2 times negative 12 is negative 24. Are there two numbers that multiply to equal negative 24 that will add up to equal 5? 8 and negative 3. Don't forget, it's called ratio method because we make a ratio with the lead coefficient. Reduce if you can. This becomes x plus 4. This second one cannot be reduced, so we get 2x minus 3 equals 0. And we solve, and we get x equals negative 4, and then positive 3 over 2. So negative 4, positive 3 over 2. Take a look at this. Negative 4, negative 1, positive 3 over 2. So we just found the zeros of our function. Let's go back up here for a second. We got two negatives and a positive. So it was this right here. Descartes' rule of signs worked. Let's go and do another one. And we're going to start this problem from the beginning. So same routine. We look at our positive real roots, and we will not have any because there are no sign changes in our original function. So now we will look to see how many negative real roots we'll have. So this stays positive, second term turns negative. This stays positive, this turns negative, the 4 stays positive. 1, 2, 3, 4 sign changes, which means we may have 4 negative real roots, we might have 2 negative real roots, or we might not have any. Keep in mind, these should add up to 4 because our degree is 4. And now we fill in the gaps for our imaginary numbers so that the numbers across, left to right, add up to 4. Here's what's great about this problem. We do not have to test any positive real roots because there are none. So let's look at our possible numerators, which we get from our constant. The factors of our constant are 1, 2, and 4. The factors of our lead coefficient also happen to be 1, 2, and 4. And we make all possible fractions out of these numbers, and keep in mind, we only have to test the negatives. So negative 1, negative 2, negative 4. 2 over 2 would give us the 1. 4 over 2 would give us the 2. Now we have 1 over 4, so again, only negatives. 2 over 4 is negative 1 half. And 4 over 4 we already have as negative 1. So these are the numbers we're going to test using synthetic division. So we make our pocket. We write down our coefficients. Remember, if we had to put a placeholder, we would put the placeholder, but we don't need one in this case. Okay, again, we're looking for zeros, so we know this is going to be 4, we know this is going to be negative 4, and now we're going to test some values. By the way, when I'm doing these, I usually write this part in pen. And then I use pencil to try to substitute in so I can keep erasing and not erase all my important numbers. So let's see what we have. I'm going to try negative 1. Negative 4 is 0. 0, add down. Negative 1 times 17 is negative 17. Add down. Negative 1 times negative 1. Didn't work. Erase. Now let's try another one. So again, we didn't get negative 1. Let's try negative 2. Negative 2 times 4 is negative 8. Add down. Negative 2 times negative 4 is 8. Add down. Oh. Hey, boo-boo. It's 25. Negative 2, you can tell it's not going to work. So negative 2 is not one of our roots. All right, let's try another one. Oops, can't get my pen. So So we know that doesn't work. Let's try negative 4. Negative 4 times negative 4 is negative 16. Add down. Negative 4 times negative 12 is 48. Add down. 5, carry the 1, 65. Oh, this isn't going to work either. So we can erase. You can see that that's not going to work. We weren't even getting close to the right answers. Let's cross that out. All right, negative 1/4. I know you love your fractions. Negative 1/4 times 4 is negative 1. Add down. Now we might want to do a little work over here. Negative 1/4 times 3 is negative 3/4. Add down. We're going to get 16 and 1/4. Let's see here. It doesn't look like it's going to work. We would have to convert 16 and 1/4. 16 times 4 plus 1 would be 65 over 4. And then do negative 1/4 times that. Oh, let's see. Negative 65 over 16. Not looking like it's going to work. So we'll cross that one out and erase. So let's see if it's 1/2. Negative 1/2 times 4 is negative 2. Add down. Negative 1/2 times 2 is negative 1. Add down. Negative 1/2 times 16 is negative 8. Add down. Negative 1/2 times 8 is negative 4. Yay, it worked. Now, please remember, because we had a fraction in the pocket, we must divide all of these by the denominator. So we actually get 2, 1, 8, and negative 4. This is 2x to the third plus 1x squared plus 8x minus 4. So we cannot use our quadratic methods yet. But what we're going to do here is we're going to test and see if negative 1/2 is a double root. Because remember, if it's a double root, what that means is the polynomial would bounce off and do something like this. So let's check it. Negative 1/2 times 1 is negative 1. That gives us a 0 here. Negative 1/2 times 0 is 0. That gives us 8. Negative 1/2 times 8. Oh, sorry, this was supposed to be positive 4. Positive 4. Negative 1/2 times 8 is negative 4, which gives us 0. So, yay, we got another one. And now, again, we have to divide by 2. So this leaves us with x squared plus 4 equals 0. Well, how do we solve this? Let's see. We can't factor it, so we can set it. So we move the 4 over, subtract the 4, and now take the square root, and guess what we got? Positive and negative 2i, because we're taking the square root of a negative. So that means our zeros are positive and negative 2i, and negative 1/2, which is a double root. So two imaginaries and a negative. Let's see what our chart told us. Two imaginaries and two negatives. Sorry, it's a double root. Two imaginary and two negatives. So we've completed the problem. We found the zeros, double root at negative 1/2, and then two imaginary roots. So here's what you're going to do for homework. You're going to finish the next part of the problems on worksheet 7.5A. You're going to write out P over Q and the possible zeros of the function, and then you're going to use synthetic division to try and find the zeros of that function. Okay? You've got this. Good luck. Email me if you have any questions. I hope this was clear.